It's polarizing when you hear speeches not only in this house but even when you consider opinions outside this house. It's polarizing on ethnic lines, and on that basis the tragedy is that this house has deteriorated in its conduct to such a point where differing opinions are not respected, differing opinions are not allowed to be voiced, and one then in that backdrop has to ask the question whether there is any point in speaking. But despite that, it is my duty by the people who elected me to express certain views, which I will endeavor to do. Honorable presiding member, in May 2009, the date was the 16th, I was approached by the LTT's political head, at that time Mr. Nadesan, and Mr. Pulithevan, who was in charge of the Peace Secretariat, to approach the government of the day. There were nearly 150,000 to 100,000 people in LTT controlled areas on the 16th of May 2009. And the LTT's position was that if the government was not approached and if the LTT's wish to save those lives of civilians was not expressed and conveyed, those lives will be lost. And on that basis, I contacted the then minister, Mr. Basil Rajapaksa, on numerous occasions on the 16th, from about 4 o'clock in the afternoon till about 10 in the night. I think we must have discussed 10 times the modalities with regards to how those civilians could be brought across. Eventually, with the Defense Ministry consultation, it was agreed around 8 o'clock in the night that Mr. Basil Rajapaksa and myself will personally go to Vanni along with two bishops that the government and we will agree upon, who will oversee the whole process by which these civilians will come across. And this agreement was reached at about 8 o'clock on the 16th, pending the Security Council approval, which was to take place on the next day, because His Excellency President Mahinda Rajapaksa was away in Jordan for the non-aligned movement meeting, and he was only returning on the 17th morning. When he was to return, he was supposed to go into a National Security Council meeting immediately, and approval was supposed to be sought, and we were to be ready to go to Vanni to ensure that those civilians be brought across. Now, it was 150,000 to 100, and I make those large numbers. There is a discrepancy of nearly 50,000 because it was almost impossible to give a safe number. But those numbers were massive by any stretch of imagination, by any stretch of imagination. And at about 11 o'clock, after the National Security Council meeting had started, at about 11 o'clock when I was looking at the TV, the government's channels, Rupavahini and ITN, announced that all civilians had been brought across. About 50,000 civilians had come across, and that there was no more civilians in LTT-controlled areas. I panicked, because I know that when the war started in LTT-controlled areas, there were over 460,000 civilians. These were government figures. These were government figures. And gradually, from people coming out, as well as deaths, the calculations made by not only the TNA, but all other responsible institutions that were monitoring the war, knew that the numbers, even at the very end, were large. The Honorable Sarath Veerasekar the other day asked, where was I? That was my job. I was a member of parliament at that time. I was trying to, in some way, use my privileges as a member of parliament and my contacts with the government to try and safeguard those civilians. The LTT was willing to allow them to be brought across. But that did not happen. That did not happen. From the inception of the war, please don't disturb, Honorable Minister, you, please, yes, don't disturb. I only have a very short time.
When you are trying to mislead this assembly, you can't mislead them because the entire nation is listening. When you are trying to mislead, it is my duty, being an officer in the war, right? It is my duty to tell you that, correct it. And about 300,000 people were used as human shield by Prabhakaran. Are you going to dispute that fact? Are you going to dispute that fact?
Right.
No, you are telling lies.
Yes, Mr. Ponnambalam, you can continue with your speech.
In my submissions, you must not disturb me like this. Be responsible, please.
Yes, Mr. Sanatwansinga.
I am not arguing with you. I am giving you some more details. 19th April, we attacked the LTT line at Pudumathalan, took 120,000 civilians out. They have all recorded everything. Then on the... See, let me finish. Listen. 16 night. Again, May...
Yes, Honourable Member Ponnambalam, you can continue with your speech.
If this is going to happen, then I might as well stop speaking. If you are going to allow these members to disturb me...
We are running short of time. Yes, you can finish it in a jiffy. Yes.
There is no point in allowing me to speak in this way.
All right. Mr. Sanat Fonseca.
16 night... Nobody came, you never came. Army attacked the Mulatiu line and took 85,000 out. Yes. So these are the facts.
Right, Mr. Ponnambalam, you can continue with your speech.
So 460,000 more civilians were in LTT controlled areas when the war began. But the government, from the very inception, was saying that there were only 70,000 civilians in LTT controlled areas. You can't deny that. Food and medicine were sent for only 70,000 people. Only 70,000 people, Honorable Chairperson. That is the truth. That is what the government did. And eventually 320,000 people came out. They were kept in Manik Farm and various other places. So when you have a situation, Honorable Presiding Member, where a government lies about the numbers, where the government sends only a fraction of the population's worth of food and medicine in a war situation, what is the intention? Even on the 16th of May 2009, I personally am witness when I contacted the Honorable Basil Rajapaksa and conveyed to the government that the LTT was willing to lay down arms to allow the civilians across safely, that war was not stopped. What is the intention that you can derive from that? Isn't it the intention to destroy in whole or in part? Isn't it that the intention that is being demonstrated? This is the reality that is known to the Tamil people, Honorable Presiding Member. That is why I said this ministry is the most polarizing ministry to speak on. This is the reality that we live with, where over 164,000 people are unaccounted for. So when that is the situation, Honorable Presiding Member, a responsible government, today Honorable Member from the Opposition, the Honorable Member from the Opposition stated that over 52 senior members of the military don't get visas to countries. Why is it that members so senior are being denied visas? Isn't it the duty of the government, therefore, if these senior members in fact are innocent, to prove their innocence? Isn't it in your interest to do that? Isn't that what we are asking? Have an inquiry. Agree to an international inquiry. You have nothing to hide, then why do you shy away? Don't do that. Don't do that, because for as long as you shy away,
Honorable Member, Honorable Member, LTT gave weapons to children, underage children, bombs and cyanide.
Honorable Ponnambalam.
So for as long as you shy away, not only will your own image in the eyes of the international community be run down, but you will continue to polarize society within this own country. The defense ministry, honorable presiding member, is so polarized that is, as far as the Tamils are concerned, you should change the name of the ministry. The ministry should be called Tamil Genocide Ministry or Anti-Tamil Ministry. That is how we feel. That is how we feel. Why do you deny that? The Honorable Sarat Veerasekara is now in charge of police. He stands up in this court, in this house, and says that the honorable members of the TNA must be banned. He says that the honorable members of the TNA must be banned.
Sumit Mantituma.
Mantitumiya, Murasan Suda, Visheshem Ape, Mantituma, Adas Dekwametana, May Amatyanshe, Demala Jatiya Ghataneka Amatyanshe Namkaran Dona Kila. Metuma Sampura Jatiya Purna.
Honorable Mantituma with my Katal Kurganan.
The Honorable Sarat Veerasekara, the Honorable Sarat Veerasekara stood up shamelessly, a man who is in charge of policing. A minister stands up and says that the TNA must be banned. They must be thrown out of this house. Is this what a minister who is in charge of policing says? The Honorable Mahinder Samarasinghe on the 23rd made a speech. The poor member thought that he was praising. The poor member.
Honorable member, you have two more minutes.
The Honorable Mahinda Samarasinghe boasted that President Mahinda Rajapaksa didn't want to allow the civilians to come across. When there were different countries, different individuals like myself trying to intervene to save those civilians, the Honorable Mahinda Samarasinghe says, he boasts, saying that President Rajapaksa didn't want the civilians to come across because Prabhakaran might escape. For one man, you chose to destroy thousands and thousands of lives. That is what is called war crimes. That is what is called genocide, where you choose to destroy the lives in whole or in part. For God's sake, Honorable Member, please, for God's sake, the future of this country is going to get an inheritance of this culture. Of this culture. That should not be allowed. There are senior members on this front bench. They are not racist. I know they are not racist. There are people who might have differing views. But at least they are not racist. But that cannot be said. That cannot be said of senior members who are being appointed today. And that too to appointments on security and on public security. Can you are you allowing this language? These are hooligans, honorable member. These are not honorable members. These are hooligans.
කරුණාකර මන්ත්‍රීවරයා එතුමාට කතාව කරගෙන යන්න ඉඩ දෙන්න. මෙතුමාගේ අවසාන මිනිත්තුව කරුණාකර මන්ත්‍රීතුමාලා වාඩි වෙන්න.
So it is on this basis, honorable.
ඔව් චාමර මන්ත්‍රීතුමා.
දියුරුන් දීලා තියෙන්නේ මෙතුමා දියුරුන් දීලා තියෙන එක ගැන අපිට සැකයක් තියෙනවා. මොකද අපි දියුරුන් දීලා තියෙන්නේ ඔක්කොම මේ රටේ දියුරුන් දීමේ අපි කවුරුත් දියුරුන් දීලා තියෙන මෙතුමා දීලා තියෙන දියුරුම වෙන විදියකට. මේක මේ මහර දියුරුම මම
ඔනර් පොන්නම්බල ප්ලීස් කන්ටිනියු විත් යෝර් ස්පීච්. සර් මන්ත්‍රීතුමාලා එතුමාට කතාව කරගෙන යන්න එතුමාට තව මිනිත්තුවක් තියෙන්නේ.
මැඩම් the TNA is willing to give me some of their time. I just want to make a few points. You call yourselves a defense ministry for the whole country.
Honorable Sridharan. Honorable Ponnambalam, please continue with your speech.
Military, they've given me some time, they've given me 5 minutes. The defense ministry has 20 divisions in this country. 20 divisions. Of the 20 divisions, honorable presiding members, 16 are based in the Northeast. 16 are based in the Northeast. There are 6 headquarters, 4 are based in the Northeast. Whose defense? Who is your enemy? You claim here that it is only the enemy. But it is the Tamil people that you're oppressing. Is this what you want to convey for generations and generations to come? For God's sake, think again. In order to pursue your chauvinistic and racist policies, you are creating precedents today that is going to curse this country. Curse it to the point that you might quite well destroy us, but you will destroy yourselves.
Honorable Tenakon,
I wish you had the balls to talk like this against the LTT when they were giving arms to children, when they giving
not a point of
to
order.
Children.
Honorable Ponnambalam, please continue.
Thank you. Is this the precedent that you want to set? Because when you set this precedent, today it's the Tamils. Today it's the, yesterday it was the Tamils. Today it's the Muslims. Tomorrow it will be your own. It will be your own because the people who you consider your competition, you will turn against them. That will turn against them. That is the reality. This is a downward spiral, Honorable Presiding Member. And if these members, and what I mean by these members is not the hooligans who sit at the back. If these senior members, members who have been in this house for decades, members who are responsible, members who have the intelligence to meet.
You have only 2 more minutes.
If these senior members fail in their duties today, as they are failing today, if they continue to fail like this, it is this country that will go to the dogs, that you can never prevent. I have been repeatedly stating, I am an individual who was born and bred in Colombo. My friends are Sinhalese. I grew up with the Sinhalese. During the 83 riots, it was the Sinhalese people, like Mr. Ananda Vijayasekara, President's Council, like Mr. Kosala Vijayathilaka, President's Council, like Mr. Stanley Williams. These are the people who saved us. Those were Sinhalese people. Those are the Sinhalese people that I knew. But quite honestly, even 10 years ago when I came as a member, even when the LTT was there, this was not the culture. This was not the culture, madam. People were willing to listen. People were willing to answer. Even though they disagreed, were willing to answer with decorum. But it's a disaster what has come before this country. Make no mistake, you can by all means continue to disenfranchise the Tamil people. You might even succeed in your continued systematic genocide. You might even succeed in totally dismantling our identity. There might come a time that we can't even claim that we ever had a place on this island. But you will leave a legacy that will destroy yourselves. Mark my words.
Honorable Member, please sign yourselves. Up.
Thank you.
இந்த கொரோனா தொற்று எனப்படுவது உயிர்க்கொல்லியாகும். இந்த நாட்டு மக்களின் கவலைகள் பிரச்சனைகள் தொடர்பில் எவ்வித புரிதலும் இல்லை.